This is Anakin Skywalker, the most powerful Jedi of his generation, perhaps of any generation, the fastest, the strongest, an unbeatable pilot, an unstoppable warrior. He is the best there is at what he does, the best there has ever been, and he knows it. Holonet features call him the hero with no fear. And why not? What should he be afraid of? Except, fear lives inside him anyway. Children on Tatooine tell each other of the dragons that live inside the suns. Smaller cousins of the sun dragons are supposed to live inside the fusion furnaces that power everything from starships to pod racers. But Anakin's fear is another kind of dragon. A cold kind. A dead kind. Not nearly dead enough. Not long after he became Obi-Wan's Padawan, all those years ago, Anakin couldn't even remember what the mission might have been, but he'd never forgotten that dead star. It had scared him. Stars can die. It is the way of the universe, which is another manner of saying that it is the will of the Force, Obi-Wan had told him. Everything dies in time, even stars burn out. The dragon reminds him every night of how he held his dying mother in his arms, of how she had spent her last strength to say, "I knew you would come for me, Anakin." The dragon reminds him every night that someday he will lose Obi-Wan, he will lose Padme, or they will lose him. All things die, Anakin Skywalker. Even stars burn out. His agony somehow became an invisible hand stretching out through the Force. A hand that found her, far away. And now he felt her, really felt her, in the Force. But more than that, he felt a bond. A connection deeper and more intimate than he'd ever had before with anyone. Even Obi-Wan. For a precious, eternal instant, he was with her. He was the beat of her heart, and he was the motion of her lips, and he was her soft words as though she spoke a prayer to the stars. Every atom of his being screams to the Force, "How can I let her die?" The Force had no answer for him. The dragon did. All things die, Anakin Skywalker. Even stars burn out. No wisdom of Yoda's, no teaching of Obi-Wan's, not one scrap of Jedi lore came to him that could choke the dragon down. But there was an answer. One he had for years hidden from sight. It was simple. All he had to do was decide what he wanted. "I am Darth Vader," he repeated, as he ground the dragon's corpse to dust beneath his mental heel, as he watched the dragon's dust and ashes scatter before the blast from his furnace heart. "And you are nothing at all." He had finally become what they had all called him, the hero with no fear. The dark is generous, and it is patient, and it always wins. But in the heart of its strength lies weakness. One lone candle is enough to hold it back. Love is more than a candle. Love can ignite the stars. This is how it feels to be Anakin Skywalker. Forever. The first dawn of light in your universe brings pain. The light burns you. It will always burn you. Part of you will always lie upon black glass sand beside a lake of fire, while flames chew upon your flesh. You can hear yourself breathing. It comes hard and harsh, and it scrapes nerves already raw. But you cannot stop it. You can never stop it. You don't even have lungs anymore. Mechanisms hardwired into your chest breathe for you. You loved her. You will always love her. You could never will her death. Never. But you remember. You remember all of it. You remember the dragon that you brought Vader forth from your heart to slay. You remember the cold venom in Vader's blood. You remember the furnace of Vader's fury and the black hatred of seizing her throat to silence her lying mouth. And there is one blazing moment in which you finally understand that there was no dragon. That there was no Vader. That there was only you. Only Anakin Skywalker. That it was all you. Is. You. Only you. You did it. You killed her. You killed her because finally, when you could have saved her, when you could have gone away with her, when you could have been thinking about her, you were thinking about yourself. It is in this moment that you finally understand the trap of the dark side, the final cruelty of the Sith. Because now yourself is all you will ever have. And you rage and scream and reach through the Force to crush the shadow who has destroyed you. But you are so far less now than what you were. You are more than half machine, and in the end, you cannot touch the shadow. In the end, you do not even want to. In the end, the shadow is all you have left. Because the shadow understands you. The shadow forgives you. The shadow gathers you unto itself. And within your furnace heart, you burn in your own flame. This is how it feels to be Anakin Skywalker. Forever. It is intensified momentarily. Vader's own sense of anguish to his crimes. Now he added guilt at the imagination of his appearance. But then this brought him back to mind the way he used to look. Striking and grand. That hint of invincibility. With it, memories of brotherhood and home. His dear wife, the freedom of deep space. Obi-Wan. His friend, and how that friendship had turned. He knew not how until, hold. These memories he wanted none of, not now. Memories of molten lava crawling up his back. This boy had pulled him from that pit. Here now with this act, this boy was good. This boy was good, and this boy had come for him. So there must have been good in him, too. He smiled up again at his son, and for the first time loved him. And for the first time in many long years, loved himself again.